गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। इज इट विजिबल? इज इट विजिबल? गुड मॉर्निंग आ।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
इज इट विजिबल? इज इट विजिबल नाउ?
यस सर।
ओके, शुड वी प्रोसीड? ऑलरेडी रिकॉर्डिंग स्टार्टेड, पीपल हैव टू जॉइन। ओके, anyway we'll go ahead. Okay, it's their wish. Okay, if they want they can join late, it's up to them. Okay, so hope it is visible now. Should I continue?
Yes sir.
So it is very very important today's class. So what we'll see, we have started with fifth chapter now in the Aurora book. Today we'll see something about how we can classify the soil. Okay, so till now we have studied liquid limit, plastic limit, sinkage limit for all our clay soil, fine grain soil and so on. Now actual classification, how generally we do it, what is Indian standard code says, or what India follows for classification. So before going to what India follows, let us see the unified soil classification. Okay, there are so many classification. Okay, I don't want to confuse you. So directly we'll go to point exactly what is required for us. Okay, so there are some different classifications are there, so you would be more confused if I start explaining everything. So what is required for your competitive exams or semester exams, so that is only we'll concentrate. Okay, so this unified soil classification was again the developed by the Casagrande, the who has developed liquid limit now. So this fellow has developed it, and even American Society of Testing Material AAS team also following this particular classification. Okay, so first we see this ASTM and this unified soil classification. So Indian classification also exactly the unified soil classification only, because generally we try to copy from the previous Indian codes or British code and will modify according to our requirements. So here if you see, G is the gravel symbol. Okay, S is for the sand. Okay, but M is given for the silt. Okay, so here M is obtained from the Swedish word called mo. Okay, so that you should remember. G for gravel, S for sand, C for clay, O for organic soil, PT for peat. Okay, PAT. So this is one symbol you should always remember it. Okay, are you able to hear? Should I continue?
Yes sir,
yes, sir, you can go.
Fine, so focus. Okay, today's class is very very important, easily you can remember everything. Now when, and one more symbol, secondary symbol is W is for well graded, like well graded sand, well graded silt and so on. Okay, likewise W we use. P is for poorly graded, M is for non plastic fines, C for the plastic fines, L for the low plasticity, H for the high plasticity, like high plasticity clay, low plasticity clay. Okay, likewise we'll give some symbols afterwards. Okay, now coming to the coarse grain and the fine grain soil. Just listen carefully. Okay, in unified soil classification. Okay, so when we call it, it's a coarse grain soil. I have told you in the beginning, the soil. Okay, if the more than 50% soil is retained on the 75 micron. Again, I am explaining you how to first we'll differentiate the coarse grain and the fine grain. Later on, we'll say in the coarse grain we have sand and gravel, in fine grain we have silt and clay. but where is that how do we generally define the coarse grain size? If the 50%, more than 50% is written on this 75 micron, is called the coarse grain soil. If the more than 50% it passes through the 75 micron, we call it as a fine grain soil. Understand? If more than 50% is passing through the 75 micron, definitely it would be a, you can call it a fine grain soil. Now, coming to the, in the coarse grain soil, when we will call it as a gravel and when we have to call it as a sand, if, listen very carefully, if the 50% and the more than 50% is written on the 4.75 mm that we have seen, 4.575, if more than 50% written on that, then it is a gravel. If it is more than 50% passing through that 4.75 mm, then it is a sand. Understand? Then it is a sand. So likewise, what we'll do is, it is defined as the fine grain soil and the coarse grain soil. Now, there are symbols. Okay. It says, in a coarse grain content, if the fines are 5%, in a coarse grain soil contains, if the fines are less than 5%, then we call it as a well graded, whether it can be sand or a gravel. If it is gravel, we call it a well graded gravel here, okay? We call it as a well graded gravel. If it is sand, we call it as a okay. If it is gravel, we call it a well graded gravel. If it is sand, well graded sand. If it is, if the fines are, you can say more than 12%, then we call it as a poorly graded gravel and poorly graded sand and so on. Okay. If the percentage of fine is in between, okay, 5 to 12%, then we will give the dual symbol. Okay. So silty gravel, well graded gravel and so on, dual symbol we will give it. Understand? Anyway, that you will see it, okay, finally. So then this is what the coarse grain and the fine grain. Now net, it is very, very beautifully the here this, what do you say, a table is given, very beautiful table, okay, so that you can easily understand what it is exactly. So look at here, this is the unified soil classification, okay? Now observe it, what you are able to see, you try to observe it. Now, look at a coarse grain soil, more than 50% written on the 75 is called the coarse grain. Understand? That we have discussed. So this is coarse grain. In the coarse grain, we have, okay, gravel and the sand. Understand? We have gravel and the sand. Now, let us take a gravel. When we call it as a gravel, if the 50% of the coarse particles are written on the 4.75, bigger side, 4.75 mm this is. More than 50% is written on that, 50% or more of coarse fraction is written on the number 4 sieve. Sieve number will vary, okay, but this one you should remember. Then we call it as a gravel. If it is sand, that means 50% are passing through this one. That means the particle size are lesser than 4.575 because it is already passed through that one. Then it is a sand. Is it clear? First, coarse grain soil, gravel, sand. When we call it as a gravel, 50% is written on the 4.75. If more than 50% passes through that one, then sand. Understand? Then we call it as a shale. Now in that, I am telling you well-graded gravel, poorly graded gravel, silty gravel, clayey gravel, this symbol, look at this symbol. Now coming to this one, when we have to call this one, gravel is common. But when we have to call well-graded, when we have to call poorly graded, when we have to call silty gravel, when we have to call clayey gravel, okay, then there are some criterias. Same thing here also, when we have to call well-graded sand, poorly graded sand, silty sand, M is for silt, okay, clay sand and so on. Well-graded sand, poorly graded sand, silty sand, clay sand. Silty sand and the clay sand. Sand is more, but it is silty. Silty sand, clay sand, but sand is more in that. But it's a clay, some fraction of clay is there, clay sand. Silty sand, okay. Likewise, gravel and the sand. Understood? Up to here, we hope you have understood, okay. What we have done is first coarse grain soil, which is 50% more than written on that 75, then we call it coarse grain. In the coarse grain soil, we have gravel and the sand, that we know it. When we have to call gravel and when we have to call sand is 50% and more than written on 4.75 mm. Gravel, if passes through that one, sand. In the sand, we have well-graded gravel, poorly graded gravel, okay, silty gravel, clayey gravel. Gravel is more, but it is silty. Silty gravel, clayey gravel. Here, gravel with the fines. This is a clean gravel. This is a clean sand. This is having some fines. Now coming to the very, very important things. Look at here, percentage of fine is given in the horizontal, this one. If the percentage of finer is less than 5%, okay, in the sand or the gravel, the percentage of 5% passing through 200 micron, okay. If less than 5%, okay, passing through number 200 cu, okay, fine, especially finer, then we call it as a poorly graded, okay, dual symbols. We call it as a well-graded gravel, poorly graded gravel, well-graded sand, or the poorly graded sand. Understand? Hope you are following. In this, well-graded or poorly graded, if the fines are less than 5%, plus there are one more criteria also. Here, look at this criteria now. In that, anyway, it is fines are below 5%. Okay, that we met. Now, here, when we have to call well-graded gravel, if the coefficient of uniformity, hope you might have, we have studied already, coefficient of uniformity and the coefficient of curvature. If the coefficient of uniformity is less than, greater than 4, and coefficient of curvature is between 1 and 3, then we call it as a well-graded gravel. This also should meet, and this also should meet. 5% fines, then we call it as a well-graded gravel. When we have to call poorly graded, not meeting both the criteria, that means it is not meeting this one, okay, both the criteria for the well-graded gravel. So well-graded gravel, this criteria also not meeting, that means it is not coming, CC is not coming between 1 and 3, it is coming somewhere, okay. And this is also not greater than 4, it is somewhere, okay. Then we call it as a poorly graded gravel. Understand? Then, when we call the silty gravel, if the Otterberg limits A or A line or a plasticity index is less than 4. Plasticity index we know, liquid limit minus plastic limit. The Otterberg limits below A line that I will explain you, okay. Our plasticity index is less than 4, then we call it as a silty gravel. If the Otterberg limits above the A line and plasticity index is greater than greater than 7, then clayey gravel. Understand? If utterable limits are in the hatched area, that I will show you, plasticity chart is there, okay? Now, up where we have finished up to here, everything is finished. We have finished this one also. Well-graded gravel, poorly graded gravel, silty gravel, clay gravel. Silty gravel, it should match this one. Clay gravel, less than or greater than 7. The plasticity index should be greater than 7. The liquidity index is greater than, less than 4. Similarly, now what we'll do is sand. When we call it the well-graded sand, if the coefficient informality is greater than 6, we have already seen. And CC should be between 1 and 3. So when we call poorly graded sand, not meeting both the criteria. Okay. Silty sand, Atterberg limits are less than 4. And the clayey sand greater than 7. Then we call it as a well-graded sand, poorly graded sand, silty sand, clay sand. Understand? If more than 12% is passing through number 200, then we call it as a clay silt, silty sand, clay gravel, silty gravel. Understand? So that means if it is in this more than 12, then we call it as a, what do you call? Silt, related to silt, silty gravel, okay, silty gravel, clay gravel, or silty sand, clay sand, and so on. If it is in between 5% and 12%, then we'll give dual symbol, like this we can give it. Silty gravel, well-graded gravel, both are dual symbols, okay? Dual symbol will begin. Anyway, we will understand further. I'll show you again other things. So this is the story about the well-graded, fine coarse grain soil. In coarse grain soil, we have divided the gravel and the sand. In the gravel, we have these things, poorly graded, well-graded, silty gravel, clay gravel, and here we have these things like sand, okay? So when we have to call this one poorly and other things, it again depends on the coefficient of uniformity and the Atterberg limits and so on and so on, so on, okay? And so on. These things depend on all these things, okay? Now, coming to the fine grain soil. When we call it the fine grain soil, we said, soil 50% or more than passing through the 200 sieve, that means 75 micron. 200 sieve here also 75 micron, okay? 75 micron. Some particle would be there, right? Just 5% would be very fine. So here, okay, 200 micron is also 75 micron. 0.0075. Fine grain soil are more than passing through that one. That already we have seen that more than 50% is passing through that. We call it as a fine grain soil. Now, here again, what we see is for classifying this fine grain soil, we have to see this plasticity chart. So, in the fine grain soil, these are the silt. LML means what? Low plasticity inorganic silt. Low plasticity. Inorganic clay, inorganic clay of low to medium plasticity. Okay, this is high. You can say low plasticity organic clay. Okay, so how we can classify this one? This is based on this particular plasticity chart. Look at this one. It's not very very difficult. Okay, first only thing is because it is very difficult to show you online everything. Now, based what you have studied is we understood the coarse grain soil, okay? What is that sand and the gravel is over. We have done it, okay? How to classify the gravel in the gravel, poorly graded gravel or well-graded gravel or silty gravel or clay gravel or the sand also, in that we have already seen that well graded sand, poorly graded sand, silty sand, clay sand, based on the fines here and the based on the Atterberg limits and the coefficient uniformity, we can classify it. You can read once again. Okay. For fine grained soil, what we need to do is fine grained soil, we can only classify based on the liquid limit and plastic limit only. Those are the only tests we have done it. Okay. But in other case, sand and the gravel, we have done the sieve analysis and we found the coefficient of uniformity and coefficient of curvature. This we have already found out, okay, in our previous classes. CU, coefficient of uniformity, okay, hope you remember D60 by D10, okay, then coefficient of curvature is D30 square by D16 to D10, okay, and I said that well-graded sand or gravel, it should be in between 1 and 3, if you recall, okay. So this thing plus these are the some other criteria to get the silty gravel, even the silt also there in the gravel, okay. In that case, it can be classified with these things, okay. Fines and the in between the fines 5% and 12%. For fine grain soil, mostly will classify based on the this plasticity chart, very, very important. They will ask in the all competitive exams, okay. What is the because this is the research output of Casagrande, okay. So what he says is he has given the A line. This he has drawn, okay. And the y-axis he has done plasticity index, and the x-axis liquid limit. Okay. So liquid limit and this is plasticity index. What is the definition of plasticity index? Liquid limit minus plastic limit. Here this one plasticity index. So we has done his research and the plotted, and so we are following his research. Okay, what he says, he has given one line which is called A line. Okay, A Casagrande A line. So sometimes in the competitive exam they will ask this A line formula. Plasticity index is equal to 0.7. Don't ask me from where you got it. He has done some research and the based on that he has given this line will have this equation. Okay, 0.73 liquid limit minus 20 is the A line. He has drawn one A line with the here is the liquid limit 20. And in one vertical line he has drawn, okay, to classify it at 50. What he says is above the A line are clay, below the A line are silt. That you must remember. Understand, here they have written, okay. So Atterberg limits above A line and the plastic index is greater than 7, and if it is above A line, okay. Now for this this kind of soil, okay, fine grained soils, so he has given the plasticity chart. Here what he has done is at the 50 he has drawn one line to classify it, and here one A line, this is A line, yellow line he calls it as a clay, below it can be silt or a organic clay, you can say, okay. Silt or organic. Here, then what he says is, if the liquid limit is more than 50%, then it is high compressible clay. If the liquid limit is below the 50, it is a low compressible clay. What is CH and CL? Here, CH is high plasticity and high compressible inorganic clay, CH. Okay, what is CL? Inorganic clay of low or medium plasticity. L is low, okay. High, H is high. This is clay and this is clay. Low compressible or medium compressible clay. Inorganic clay, okay. For organic clay and L, he has given only one classification, that is PT, peat, muck, and the other highly, earth peat, we call it as organic clay. Rest is all inorganic. These are all inorganic, whether it may be silt or clay, inorganic. Okay. So above A line, he says that clay, below that silt. Okay. In this A line, if the high compressible clay, when we call it as high compressible clay, if it is more than 50% liquid limit, we call it as high compressible or okay, high plasticity clay. less than this one, low. Okay. Now below that one, it calls it as a silt. H is silt, right? M is silt. Low plasticity silt. ML is what? Inorganic silt with low plasticity, ML. Or OL. OL. Organic low plasticity, organic silt. Okay. Then OH, MH or OH. MH is inorganic silt with high plasticity, H. Okay. Then OH, this organic clay of medium of high plasticity. Okay. So it can be classified like this. If the plasticity index is in between 4 and 7, understand? If the plasticity index is in between 4 and 7, then we have to give the dual symbol, that is CLML or likewise CLML. Hope you are following. If the plasticity index is more than 7, then it will be a clay. Okay. If the plasticity index is less than 4, okay. But if it is in between, plasticity index is, okay, in between the hatched area, okay, then we have to give the dual symbol CLML, CLML like that, okay. So both clay also is there, silt also will be in between. Understand? So likewise, this unified soil classification is classified. This is based on the plasticity chart for fine grained soil, okay. Above A line is the clay, below A line is the silt. But if it is more than 50% of liquid limit, then highly clay or a silt can be highly here, H. If it is below 50, it can be low silt or a low clay. Understand? And we will also see the plasticity index values also, okay. If the plasticity index value more than 7, okay, then it falls in clay. Below that one, silt. In between, we have to give the dual symbol. So this is all about the unified soil classification. Now what we'll do is our Indian standard classification system. It is exactly the same. We have copied almost exactly the same. Only difference is here, what we have done is, we have given little elaborate about the, not only gravel, some other thing also. Here gravel is, when we call it as gravel, when we call it as sand, boulders and cobble, okay, it is given here, okay. So diameter more than 300, means 30 centimeter is boulder, okay. Here I go smaller than the 300, but written on the 80 is called the cobble. It is none of our business actually. We mostly focus on the gravel only. Okay. So fine gravel and all here, look at here. Okay. Coarse from here to here, coarse gravel. Okay. Fine gravel, same thing. Okay. So likewise here again, it is given. The gravel, but 4.75 is common, okay. Now, not to confuse you much, the only difference I will tell you. What is the only difference between the Indian standard code and the unified soil classification? Only one difference is, here vertical, whatever you have drawn at 50, Indian code has driven at 35. To bring I means intermediate. Or medium. Here high compressible clay, medium compressible clay and the low compressible clay. Understand? Same thing, A line also same thing. Okay, here the Casagrande has drawn 50% liquid limit. Above 50%, it is everything is high, whether it may be silt or a clay. Below 50, everything is low. But what we have done is, we have brought one more category, that is intermediate, in between. That means we have given one more line here at a liquid limit of 35. Then below that one, we call it as a low compressible clay, intermediate compressible clay and high compressible clay. That's the only difference. Everything is same, the 4 and 7, the dual symbol and everything is same, okay? Above that one and below that one, in between what symbol we have to go, everything is same. Only what is the only difference here? We have given one more line here, okay, at a below that one we call low compressible clay. Okay, so below A line everything is silt, above A line clay. In the clay, when we have to call high compressible clay, intermediate compressible clay and low compressible clay, if the liquid limit is more than 50 and if it is above the A line, okay, then we call it as a high compressible clay, okay, intermediate compressible clay and the low compressible clay. Understand? What you have to do is, first you have to do, find the liquid limit, plastic limit, shrinkage limit, and find the plasticity index, okay? And you plot the graphs, okay? And plot the graph for A line, everything you plot it, and then you check it, where our soil is falling, okay? If it is falling above A line, then everything is clay. If it is falling below A line, everything is silt. And high organic clay also would be there here, low organic okay. So this one. Now in that, whether it is highly compressible clay or low, how we have to decide if the liquid limit is in between, suppose 40, then it, and above A line, then it is CI. If the liquid limit is below 35, okay, and above the A line, then CL. Okay, plasticity index is more than 7. If it is plasticity index is 5, understand? Liquid limit also less than 35. Then it comes in this category. Then compressible, that is clay. When we call this clay, if it is more than 7, below 4 silt, if the plasticity index in between. So this is all about this soil classification and all. It is very given very clearly how to give boundary symbols. I have explained in a very short, okay? So if you want, again, we can, I'll explain you, but the thing is, you read it. So on here, again, it is a table, very clearly it is given, separate, everything is, again, it is given, when the fines are between this one, okay, then we have to give dual symbol, not meeting all criteria, A line, below A line less than 4, okay, above A line, okay, if it is in between 4 into 5, what we should give it, this is for gravel, and again this is for sand, well graded gravel, poorly graded gravel, silty gravel, and so on. Then again, sand means above 6 coefficient uniformity, okay, coefficient of curvature in if it all not all, then it would be a poorly graded sand, okay. Then again, Atterberg limits, we calculate it, okay, whether it is coming less than or IP less than 4 or greater than 7. If it is in between, again, dual symbol, and so on. Everything is given. What you need to do is, this is again for the fine grain soil. One more table is given in Aurora. Here, what we have done is ML, CL, OL, okay. So these are the symbols. Again, the greater than 4, greater than the 6, and dual symbol is in between, and so on. Very clearly given. Okay, so what you need to do is, below plot A line, above plot A line, and so this plasticity chart and soil classification very, very important, okay? So I want you to read it very, very clearly. And easily you can classify this soil. There may be some problem also given how can classify this soil. So with that, I will stop today, okay? Please read this particular chapter. One is more important is plasticity, understand. Second one is very, very clearly given the table. Okay, read the table when we have to give dual symbol, when we have to give single symbol and so on. That's what very, very clearly it is given so that easily you can classify the soil. What you have to do is just conduct the sieve analysis. If it is a coarse grain soil, if it is more than 50% passing through the 75, if it is a fine grain soil, conduct the liquid limit, plastic limit, sinkage limit and so on. Then get those values and just go to the, if it is a fine grain soil, follow the plasticity chart, draw the A line where it is, then 35, then 50 vertical lines, okay. If 35, 50 vertical lines, right, at liquid limit. These are all high compressible, these are medium, intermediate compressible, these are the low compressible, whether the above A lines are clay, below A lines are the silt, okay. And then what you need to find out is plasticity index, how much you are getting it, whether it is above 7 or below 4. Okay, if it is in between both the symbol, we can't do anything. We have to do both the symbol while classifying it. Okay, very, very simple. Maybe it looks maybe difficult now. Okay, but one reading is enough for you. You can understand everything. Okay, just one reading, but you have to read properly. Okay, so with that, I'll stop today. Let me download your attention. Why strength is very less? Who is your? Shall we start?